अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ डॉक्टर मोहम्मद मुस्तफा शहीन एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग एंडोडोंटिक मटेरियल्स। दिस इज थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन एंडोडोंटिक मटेरियल्स। इन आवर प्रीवियस टू लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स: इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ एंडोडोंटिक्स, indications and contraindication of endodontics, objectives of endodontics, procedure of endodontics, introduction of different materials used in endodontics, what is irrigation and what are irrigants, their types and properties, what is meant by intracanal medicaments used in endodontics, different types of intracanal medicaments used in endodontics, their functions and properties, limitations of intracanal medicaments in endodontics, endodontic sealers, their ideal requirements and types of sealers, and method of application of sealers. In today's lecture we will talk about absorbent paper points, its composition and uses, obturating materials, their types, gutta percha, its composition and properties, types of gutta percha, different obturation techniques, materials used in routine repair and periradicular surgery, which is surgical endodontics, MTA, what is MTA, its properties and uses, what is biodentine, its properties and uses, what is direct and indirect pulp capping procedures, and comparison between MTA and biodentine. First of all, we will talk about absorbent paper points. These absorbent paper points are made of paper or other absorbent materials like cotton. Uses of absorbent paper points are: the primary function of paper point is drawing the canal. Before doing obturation and before packing intracanal medicament, we have to dry the canal, conveying a medicaments. We can also use paper points to put intracanal medicament into the canal, obtaining canal cultures, and these paper points are available in standardized size. Obturation. What is obturation? Obturation means to fill the shaped and debrided canal space with a temporary or permanent filling material. Obturation technique: the method used to fill and seal a cleaned and shaped root canal using a root canal sealer and core filling material. Sealers are frequently used as the solo obturating material in deciduous teeth. There are a variety of techniques used to obturate the canal space, which will be discussed later on. Different obturating materials available for endodontics are: we divide these materials into two categories. One is core obturating materials and the other one is sealers. Sealers have been discussed in previous lecture, which are zinc oxide eugenol based sealers, resin based sealers, glass enamel based sealers, and calcium hydroxide based sealers. Now we will talk about core obturating materials, which are of two types: solid materials and semi solid paste. Semi-solid paste is available in the form of para formaldehyde paste and aeroform paste. These pastes are not used in aeronautics nowadays because of their some adverse effects. For example, formaldehyde paste sets into hard mast, so it is very difficult to remove this paste from the canal if we have to do re-endo. And the other side effect of paraformaldehyde paste is it is very toxic to periradical tissue. So if in any case it crosses the apex and it can cause irritation or inflammation of the periradical tissue and can cause dysesthesia or anesthesia of periradicular area. Because of these serious side effects, paraformaldehyde paste is not used. While the iodoform paste is specially used in the obturation of serious teeth, because it does not get hard on setting, and it can resorb. So when permanent teeth erupt, iodoform paste get resorbed with the root resorption of deciduous teeth. Solid materials are further divided into three categories. One is resin based core obturating materials. Second one is silver points or dental amalgams. And third is gutta percha. Gutta percha is further divided into two or three categories, which are regular gutta percha or beta phase gutta percha, thermoplasticized gutta percha, which is alpha phase. Thermoplasticized gutta percha has two types, one is injectable and the other one is carrier based. First of all, we will look upon silver based obturation material. Silver is used in the form of prefabricated cones. Not always fits to the anatomy of the root canals. Silver undergoes corrosion. One way is to fill the canal completely with silver. The other way is that silver may also be used to fill only the apical 5 to 6 mm of the canal, while the rest of the canal is filled with some other material. Next is gutta percha. It is very important and most commonly used obturating material. Gutta percha is latex derivative, which is transpolyisoprene. It has two crystalline forms, one is alpha and other one is beta. Composition of gutta percha is very important. Gutta percha is comprised of transpolyisoprene 19 to 22%, zinc oxide 60 to 75%, resins, waxes, antioxidants, metallic salts. Functions and features or properties of gutta percha points are non-soluble, non-irritant points that are condensed into the pulp chamber during obturation. The gutta percha points used cold or heated are used together with the sealer, does not adhere to the canal wall, which results in leakage. Gutta percha points do not strengthen root as it do not adhere to dentine. Inability to control micro leakage and the solubility of sealer. Types of gutta percha are solid core gutta percha points, which may be standardized or not standardized. Next is thermomechanical compatible gutta percha, and the third one is thermoplasticized gutta percha, which is available in solid core system and injectable form, and the fourth one is medicated gutta percha. Next is obturation techniques. We use three obturation techniques in dentistry. One is lateral condensation, the other one is vertical condensation, and third one is thermoplasticized condensation technique. Vertical condensation. Gutta percha is warmed using a heated instrument and then packed vertically. After a heated spreader is used to remove the coronal segment of the master cone, a cold plugger is used to apply vertical pressure to the softened master cone. Obturation of the coronal portion of the canal is accomplished by adding a gutta percha segment. A heated spreader is used to soften the material. A cold plugger is then used to apply pressure to the softened gutta percha. This is an animation video in which you will see vertical condensation technique.
In a traditional vertical condensation down-pack technique, the heat carrier is inserted into the gutta percha mass a few millimeters. The change in color indicates that heat is being transferred a few millimeters down through the mass of gutta percha. The heat is then turned off and the instrument is removed. Some gutta percha will stick to the cooling instrument as it is removed. A pre-fitted plugger is introduced to compress the gutta percha that has remained in the canal space. This plugger is worked around the canal to push the gutta percha down and compress it into nearby lateral canals and anastomoses. The plugger is then held on top of the gutta percha mass for about 5 seconds as it cools. This helps to minimize shrinkage. The heat carrier is again inserted. It is taken a few millimeters deeper into the gutta percha mass. As the power is turned off, the heat carrier is removed and another ball of thermosoftened gutta percha adheres to the instrument. Again, a pre-fitted plugger is inserted to circumferentially compact the remaining gutta percha. In this animated example, the plugger pushes the gutta percha within 5 or 6 millimeters of the apex. The plugger is again held against the gutta percha mass as it cools. The plugger is then removed, showing a completed downpack obtained with the vertical condensation technique, which is ready for backfill.
So I hope you will have understand what is vertical condensation technique. Next is lateral condensation. Lateral condensation technique may be a cold lateral condensation or warm lateral condensation. Cold lateral condensation. A cylinder is adapted against prepared canal and master gutta percha point placed in prepared canal, followed by tapered gutta percha points and compacted against canal wall under pressure using spreaders. Gutta percha points removed from orifice with hot instrument and the tooth restored temporarily. In warm lateral condensation, the rest of the procedure is same as in cold lateral condensation, but uses a warm spreader after the initial cold lateral condensation. Finger spreaders can be heated in a flame or special electronically heated device. This is an animation video of electrocondensation techniques. You can see first he select the master cone, then put the sealer, and then put master cone with sealer, and then put additional gutta-percha points to fill the space, and then use spreader to condense the gutta-percha points, and then put again an additional gutta-percha point to seal the canal, and then cut the gutta-percha points from orifice with the help of a heated instrument. This is the lateral condensation technique, called lateral condensation technique. Next is thermoplasticized. Thermoplasticized technique. In thermoplasticized technique, we can use syringe insertion, which is obtura, and solid core insertion, which is thermophile. In syringe insertion, this system includes a delivery gun in which gutta-percha pellets are inserted into this device and heated to temperatures ranging from 185 degree centigrade to 200 degree centigrade. And in solid core insertion, thermophile, these are cores of metals or plastics coated with gutta-percha. They are heated in an oven and pushed into prepared canals to correct length. Finally, with a burr, the core is cut off. Next is resilon, which are resin-based obturating materials. Resilon material is a thermoplastic synthetic polymers of polyester, which is polycaprolactone polymer, Rotuna filling material. Resilon materials contains bioactive glass and radio opaque fillers. Resilon system comprises of core plus primer plus resin sealer, which is epiphany. Resilon system is basically a monoblock core system, which also reinforces tooth structure and prevents bacteria ingress. Monoblock concept came in 2004 in advent of bondable rod filling materials, in which resilon, which is polycaprolactone based dimethacrylate resin, which also contain bioactive, is used with a primer and a dual core sealer, which is epiphany. This material looks and handles like conventional gutta-percha, but unlike gutta-percha, resilon obturators bond to its associated sealer, which is epiphany sealer. Composition of resilon is thermoplastic synthetic polymer, polyester, barium sulfate, bismuth chloride, and bioactive glass. Bioactive glass releases calcium and phosphate ions from its surface on exposure to bodily fluids, which stimulate bone growth, which results in a reinforcement of tooth structure. The resilon may be used for both lateral and vertical condensation, as well as with obtura system. Resilon has better resistance to leakage, superior reinforcement of root structure, and lesser degradation in oral fluids comparable to conventional gutta-percha. It is expensive and time-consuming technique and very technique sensitive. This is animation video of thermoplasticized gutta-percha. obturation technique.
X-ray to check the completion of the obturation.
Well, this was the thermoplasticized obturation technique. Next, we will discuss about periradicular or endodontic surgery. Endodontic surgery is a surgical procedure performed to remove or correct the causative agents of radicular or periradicular disease and to restore these tissues to functional health. It is often the last hope for retention of a tooth and therefore requires our greatest skill. Materials used for root canal repair and periradicular surgery are MTA, which is mineral trioxide aggregate, and biodentine. First of all, we will talk about MTA, which is mineral trioxide aggregate. Composition of MTA is comprised of tricalcium silicate, dicalcium silicate, tricalcium aluminate, tetracalcium aluminum, ferrolite, calcium sulfate, and bismuth oxide. Clinical applications of the MTA are: MTA is used for direct pulp capping and indirect pulp capping, pulpotomy, percussion perforation to treat root resorption. MTA is used in retro obturation. MTA is used for apexogenesis and apexification. Apexogenesis is done in vital root, and apexification is done in non-vital root, which is obviously apical plug. And MTA is also used to treat radicular resorption. Mechanism of action of MTA is: when MTA is placed in direct contact with human tissues, it creates an antibacterial environment by its alkaline pH. MTA modulates cytokines production, encourages differentiation of hard tissue producing cells, and forms hydroxyapatite on the MTA surface and provides a biological seal. In case of pulp capping, pulp exposure following caries excavation, mineral trioxide aggregate is placed over the exposed pulp in which can be seen in picture B, and in picture C you can see a radiograph showing mineral trioxide aggregate placement immediately after pulp capping, and in picture D you can see a 6-month follow-up radiograph of that tooth. What is the apical plug? For necrotic pulps and with open apex, MTA can be used as a material of choice for apical plug and placed 3 to 4 millimeter in the apical plug, which is also called apexification. It creates a hard tissue formation or as an apical plug to prevent the extrusion of the filling material during obturation of the canal with open apex. MTA is also used in pulpotomy. Pulpotomy is basically done in deciduous teeth when caries have reached to the pulp chamber, and there is only partial coronal pulp infected, and the remaining apical pulp is normal, non-infected. We remove the partial infected pulp from the pulp chamber and place MTA over the remaining non-infected pulp. This procedure is usually successful in deciduous teeth. In permanent teeth, pulpotomy is not that successful. Now, properties of MTA. MTA is biocompatible, antimicrobial, non-resorbable, minimum leakage. MTA has compressive strength, which develops over a period of 28 days more than 133 megapascal. MTA has low or non solubility. Initial pH of MTA is 10.2, and after 3 hours, it reaches up to 12.5, which remains constant. MTA sets in the presence of moisture. MTA is radiopaque, and setting time is about 2 hours and 45 minutes. Next material is biodentine. Biodentine is a calcium silicate based product which became commercially available in 2009 by a Septodont company, which also manufactured other endodontic material as well. And biodentine was specifically designed as a dentine replacement material. Biodentine composition is powder is packed in a capsule, and liquid is packed in a pipette. Powder contain tricalcium silicate, which is main core material, dicalcium silicate, calcium carbonate, iron oxide, which is added for shade, and zirconium oxide, which is added for radioopacity. In liquid, there is calcium chloride, which is accelerated, hydrosoluble polymer, which is water reducing agent, and play a role in faster setting, and liquid also contain water. Mechanism of action of biodentine is biodentine induces mineralization after its application. Mineralization occurs in the form of osteodentine that form reparative dentine. The ability to release calcium is a key factor for a successful pulp capping therapies because of the action of calcium on differentiation, proliferation, and mineralization of pulp cell, which are osteoblast, cementoblast, and odontoblast. This is again mechanism of action of biodentine. Properties of biodentine are same as MTA, but there are some advantages over MTA, which are ease of handling, shorter setting time, and highly purified ingredients, and it can set either in dry or wet condition. If we compare the properties of MTA and biodentine, powder liquid ratio for MTA is 3:1, and for biodentine, one capsule powder we will add 5 drops of liquid. Manipulation, MTA is mixed on glass slab manually with the help of mixing simmer spatula, while the biodentine is mixed in amalgamator for 30 seconds. Setting time of MTA is initial setting time is 70 minutes, and final setting time is 175 minutes. And initial setting time of biodentine is 6 minutes, and final setting time is 10 to 12 minutes. Density of MTA is 1.88 gram per centimeter cubic, and density of biodentine is 2.26 gram per centimeter cubic. Porosity for MTA is 22.6%, and for biodentine is 6.8%. Compressive strength, after 1 hour MTA has very less compressive strength, and after 24 hours compressive strength is 7.5 megapascal for MTA, and after 1 hour biodentine has almost 131.5 megapascal compressive strength, and after 24 hours it reaches up to 241.1 megapascal. Mechanical resistance of MTA is lower, while the biodentine has higher mechanical resistance. Clinical application of the biodentine is same as of MTA, which are obviously pulp exposure. Biodentine is used in case of pulp exposure, which can be a direct which can be used in our direct pulp capping procedure or indirect pulp capping procedure. MTA is also used in pulpotomy for apexification, for apical surgery, for apexogenesis. Abandotin is also used to treat internal or external resorption for proliferations, and abandotin is also used for dentine caries. In top picture, you can see a indirect pulp capping with biodentine after removing the whole caries. Biodentine is put into the cavity, and which is later on replaced with permanent filling material. It will help in the formation of tertiary dentine. In bottom picture, you can see direct pulp capping procedure. It is usually done in case of pulp exposure because of trauma, not because of caries. In picture, you can see that there is a red spot, which is actually pulp exposure. After achieving the hemostasis, you will cover the open pulp with the help of biodentine, and after that we will wait for tertiary dentine formation, and later on we will do a permanent restoration. Next is obviously biodentine is used in water pulpotomy. The rate of success of water pulpotomy with biodentine is higher than MTA and pulpotec. In pulpotomy, as I previously told, water pulpotomies are done in deciduous teeth where there is a partial coronal infected pulp, which is removed with the help of excavator, and after achieving the hemostasis, the remaining infected apical pulp is covered with biodentine, and temporary or permanent filling is done. Biodentine is also used for the repair of perforations. So this is the animation video of periapical surgery, which is also called apicectomy.
Animation demonstrates apical surgery. When a tooth has pulpal problems, it may have pathology, such as a cyst at the tip of the root. It starts out small, but can grow and destroy bone as it expands. Root canal therapy is usually performed to correct this situation. However, root canal therapy may not always be successful, and the pathology can continue to grow. Surgical correction involves first raising a flap. And then removing some bone over the pathology to provide access. There are special small drills to help the dentist or root canal specialist to perform this microsurgery. The pathology at the tip of the root is then removed. Here we carefully remove a cyst that has formed and grown to significant size. If the size of the area is large, surgical correction is mandatory, along with root canal treatment. To prevent reoccurrence, the tip of the root is sectioned. Then the root canal opening is prepared again with special small drills or ultrasonic instruments. Finally, a filling is placed into the prepared site to seal the opening. The flap is repositioned and sutured into place. The sutures are removed or they will dissolve. This procedure surgically and immediately removes the pathology. After a period of time, the bone area fills in the defect and the tooth is saved.
So this was the video of apicectomy procedure. So this table shows comparison between the uses of MTA and biodentine. MTA is used for pulp capping, partial pulpotomy, pulpotomy, root canal filling, perforation repair, which could be apical or lateral perforation, perforation resorption repair, external or internal root and filling to form apical barrier for tooth with necrotic pulp and open apex and sealers and others. Uses of biodentine are pulp capping, repair of root perforation, apexification, root end filling, as dentine substitute, base for posterior restoration, resorptive lien and retrograde filling के लिए भी यूज़ करते हैं biodentine को. Okay, the topic of endodontic materials has come to its end. These are the whole endodontic materials. I hope you have understand these endodontic materials. Thank you so much.